Hello and welcome to Anatomy and Physiology at Glen Oaks Community College. I'm Dr. Ren Hartung. For this video, we're going to look at the male reproductive system using this anatomy model that we have. So we'll start with this, of course, is representing the male reproductive system. This is the scrotum that surrounds the testicle or the testicles. This would be the left testicle here, and if I open this up, that's supposed to be the right testicle, and the right testicle in cross section, so you can see part of the epididymis. This is the testicle. This is the epididymis. The spermatic cord is basically all of these blood vessels and the vas deferens and the nerves that come down into the scrotum that service the testicle. It usually doesn't look quite like this. I have another model that does a better job for spermatic cord. The vas deferens or ductus deferens is this tube that leads from the testicle up over the pelvic bone, over the top of the male bladder, which is here, and into the back of the bladder where it's going to connect to the ejaculatory duct. The ejaculatory duct on this model is represented right here. That's a piece of it. And as long as we have it open like this, this is the prostate gland. And on this part of the model, it's better to show these things. This is the prostate gland. This again is the ejaculatory duct. The male urethra, of course, leads from the male bladder down through the penis and out of the body. It has three major parts. The prostatic urethra, which is inside of the prostate. The membranous urethra, which is between the prostate and the penis. So this little section here is the membranous urethra. And then the penile urethra, which goes, of course, the length of the penis. It's also called the spongy urethra because the erectile tissue that surrounds the urethra is here. Bulbourethral glands on this model are represented by a little circle back here. This model is not really correct about this. The bulbourethral glands wouldn't be seen on this kind of section, and I think that's why they made it just this tiny circle. They would be actually deep to what we're looking at here. Penis itself, of course, is here. Erectile tissues of the penis surrounding the urethra. We have the corpus spongiosum in kind of a reddish color here. And then superiorly to the corpus spongiosum is the corpus cavernosa. And the corpus cavernosa compared to the spongiosum, to really see what they look like, I'd have to draw you a picture in cross-section of the penis. The glans penis is the head of the penis down here. And the foreskin on this model, I kind of like this model because it shows you this is what a penis might look like without a foreskin. In other words, a circumcised penis. A penis with a foreskin would look more similar to this. So we've got this extra skin basically that comes down and covers the head of the penis. So again, this area, this skin up here that surrounds the head would be considered the foreskin. Other things that we can look at on here for urinary system, this of course again is the urinary bladder, and this is the urethra with its three parts, the prostatic urethra, the membranous urethra, and the spongy urethra or penile urethra. And then inside again, just like we had on the female model, we have a right ureter, and if we follow that ureter up inside of the model, it'll lead us to the right kidney or the very bottom part of the right kidney. So those are the urinary structures that you can see on this model. For digestive system on this model, you can see again part of the sigmoid colon, just like on the female model. You can see the rectum here and the anus. or the anal canal, excuse me. Anus is the what you can see from the outside, the opening from the outside. And I think that's everything I can show you on the male reproductive model, on this male reproductive model. Thank you again for watching.